Anyway, see the chip there? Mm-hmm. It communicates with the roach's antenna, and then the whole thing is controlled wirelessly. I mean, the possibilities are endless.
All right, how much are these cyber roaches gonna cost me?
Soon you're gonna have every Wi-Fi, Bluetooth signal transmitting device out there.
Well, that's the idea. I'll study them, you'll hack them, and together we'll stay two steps ahead of the guys in the black hat.
Metro PD recovered a phone from a crime scene and asked us to try to get an ID on its owner. I got a binary dump off the phone, but the data was misaligned, so that's gonna take a while. The home security system was hacked.
That means somebody hacked the communication between the control panel and PTEC.
And disarmed the alarm remotely from his own device without being detected.
Grab the router, the computer, the security control box, the game console, bring it back to CTOC.
But those guys can simply harvest credit card numbers from retailers by the millions, sell them for $20 online, and never even leave the comfort of their own home.
Right.
You can set the timer to vacuum on a schedule.
The very last thing he did was play a golf game on this GameFX.
Console emits invisible infrared dots of light. I mean, they're bouncing off of everything, mapping the space. We even set up a GameVex. Now we can see what the console sees through these night vision glasses. Go ahead and put them on.
The device that was attached to Barrett's club was also equipped with GPS tracking.
But with Ray's dog, our hacker was able to intercept communication, making Marlon say whatever he wanted.
How did the hacker do this?
Means the target went after the dog, through Wi-Fi.
The only digital dust left by the target on Barrett's router is the MAC address of his device he used.
It's information requested from service providers that indicates the devices that connected with a particular tower.
And what does this information include?
Telephone numbers and a timestamp indicating when the device pinged the tower.
I not approve the burner was our hacker's phone.
Yep,
the burner was sitting right next to his laptop, inadvertently recording vibrations as he typed.
And that's our hacker's email address. Nelson, call the service provider. Let's get a location on this guy.